Great is your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with a sinner's restless heart. You lead us by still waters into mercy. And nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise of God. Your grace is enough. You lead us in the song of your salvation, and all your people sing along. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise of
Good and gracious God, you created us to be yours. To know this truth, you bless us with education to seek you. To understand your desire to be one with us, you bless us with humility to understand you. To live this union with you, you bless us with love for you as our Father. We gather in prayer with Jesus, your Son, because he shows the way to seek you, reveals the truth to encounter you, and gives us the life we have with you. Hear this prayer we make tonight. As your beloved community of students and teachers, parents and alumni of Holy Innocents High and Primary Schools, so that we can more worthily prepare ourselves for the 2023 Catholic Education Conference. We make this prayer humbly and confidently in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel according to Luke. And now a lawyer stood up and to test him asked, Master, what must I do to inherit eternal life? He said to him, what is written in the law? What is your reading of it? He replied, you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, and with all your mind, and your neighbor as yourself. Jesus said to him, you have answered right. Do this, and life is yours. But the man was anxious to justify himself and said to Jesus, and who is my neighbor? In answer, Jesus said, a man was once on his way down to Jerusalem to Jericho and fell into hands of bandits. They stripped him, beat him, and then made off, leaving him half dead. Now a priest happened to be traveling down the same road, but when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. In the same way, a Levite who came to the place saw him and passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan traveler who came on him was moved with compassion when he saw him. He went up to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring oil and wine on them. He then lifted him onto his own mount and took him to an inn and looked after him. Next day, he took out 2 denarii and handed them to the innkeeper and said, look after him, and on my way back, I will make good any extra expense you have." Which of these two do you think proved himself a neighbor to the man who fell into the bandit's hands?" He replied, "The man who showed pity towards him." Jesus said to him, "Go and do the same yourself." The Gospel of the Lord.
The parable of the Good Samaritan reminds us of God's call to love the people around us, beyond our own convenience, even our enemies. Jesus used this parable to highlight this call when he was asked by Jewish lawyers who were lost in the legalities of the religion and did not seem to understand what love truly meant. The Samaritans were relations of the Jews, but whose Jewish ancestors had intermarried with the non-Jews during the years of exile. Hence, to the pure-blooded Jews, Samaritans were seen as dirty, impure, and therefore not worthy to worship God in the Temple of Jerusalem. The Jews during Jesus' time would have seen Samaritans as beneath them, and therefore not worth their time to interact with at all. Hence, this parable that Jesus spoke of in Luke's Gospel would have shocked his Jewish listeners as he spoke of how a Levite and a priest, both men of high social and religious standing in Jewish society at that time, chose to walk past the Jewish man that was robbed and left for dead on the roadside because they did not want to be ritually unclean by touching blood. On the other hand, the victim was rescued by the unlikeliest of people, a Samaritan, who would have understandably chosen not to help a Jew. Yet, this Samaritan not only extended a helping hand to save the Jew, but offered to pay extra to the innkeeper to take care of him in the long term. It is with this understanding that both Hollinson's High School and Primary School see and carry out our mission. Our father, Father John Casimir Salus from the Foreign Missionaries of Paris, saw the need of the children in the growing fishing village in Aokang, Punggol area to have some form of education. He chose to start the school in the compound of the parish of the Nativity of the Blessed Virgin Mary to teach classical Chinese to these children. Later on, when Father Anthony Shi was left to rebuild the school in the post-war era, he saw that the students were not regular in attending school, so he would be seen on his Lambretta motorcycle going around the Aokang area, gathering the students and chasing them back to school. These men were examples for us, showing what it meant to love beyond our convenience. And therefore, during this time, the school has recognized that we are called to build a Christ-centered school community with the courage to lead and the compassion to serve. We are called to be the voice of the marginalized, to impart to our students the courage to speak truth, and to have the heart of service to lend a hand to whomsoever requires our help. May this heart of service continue to be present not only in the Holy Innocents community, but also in the mission schools in Singapore. May we continue to be training grounds to stir into the hearts of the young men and women this call to be good Samaritans to all around, so that they grow into salt of the earth and light of the world.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Let us pray. God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for choosing us to love our neighbors in the way that you first loved us, unconditionally, without counting the cost. We thank you for placing us into communities such as our schools in which we grow in the environment of love. We pray that you open our eyes to be aware of the needs of the people around us, especially the poor, the sick, the lost, the downtrodden, and the brokenhearted. May we have the generosity of heart to extend a helping hand and a listening ear to these brothers and sisters of ours. May they encounter you through these little acts of service that we render, so that they will know that they are loved as your precious sons and daughters. We make our prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. Immaculate Heart of Mary, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. All the holy innocents, pray for us.
Oh, Education is a vocation that requires a suspension of our ego. In letting go of what we think we know and what we want to do, we allow the Holy Spirit to inspire our hearts and minds with the direction the Lord Himself wants us to take. After all, if the Lord does not build the house, in vain do its builders toil. Doing the will of the Lord requires our obedience to His word, a submission to His plan. Obedience requires that we care only that Jesus is lifted up, and to Him be the glory. We must follow John the Baptist's model. Initially, John was the sole voice, crying in the wilderness to prepare the way of the Lord. Soon he needed to step aside, willingly decreasing, so that the primacy of Christ increased. As we come together for Catholic Education Conference 2023, let us be open in heart, mind and spirit to find opportunities for synergy, so that all things work together for good, according to His purpose.